Multidrug-resistant tuberculosis, resistant to isoniazid and rifampin, is diagnosed in almost 500,000 new people each year. The World Health Organization recommends a 20-month treatment course, but cohort studies in Bangladesh have shown promising results in multidrug-resistant tuberculosis using shorter regimens. This randomized non-inferiority trial of participants with rifampin-resistant TB susceptible to fluoroquinolones and aminoglycosides compared a 9 to 11-month course of treatment containing high-dose moxifloxacin, the short regimen, with the WHO-recommended 20-month course of treatment, the long regimen. The primary outcome, or favorable outcome, was defined as culture negativity during treatment and at 132 weeks post-randomization without an intervening positive culture or unfavorable outcome. An unfavorable outcome was defined as starting two or more drugs not in the allocated regimen, treatment extension beyond the permitted duration, death from any cause, a positive culture result when last seen, or not seen at 76 weeks or later. In a modified intention-to-treat analysis, 78.8% of those in the short regimen group had a favorable outcome, as compared with 79.8% of those in the long regimen group, for an HIV-adjusted difference of 1 percentage point. The 95% confidence interval did not exceed the 10 percentage point margin of non-inferiority. Both regimens had a similar frequency of severe adverse events. An increased corrected QT interval developed more frequently in patients on the short regimen. The authors conclude that in patients with MDR-TB susceptible to fluoroquinolones or aminoglycosides, a short 9 to 11-month regimen had non-inferior efficacy and comparable safety to the WHO-recommended longer regimen. Full trial results are available at NEJM.org.